I am putting a lot of stretch, okay? I'm putting too much stretch on the tape.
Greetings, fellow DIYer, and welcome to my video.
So you want to build a hexagon. That's what I'm doing here. This is a hexagon that I'm putting together to make a steady rest for my lathe. This trick works with any shape that is roughly round. So octagon, hexagon, pentagon, pretty much any gon you'll be able to use this trick on. Now, the normal way to make a hexagon would be to cut your pieces, make sure they're all exactly the same length, make sure they all have exactly the same angle, and then to slowly position them and get them exactly where you want them. But as I move this end moves and that end moves. So you get out your tape measure and you go from there to there. We go from there to there. It's close, but it's not exactly on. So then you adjust and you move stuff and then you have to clamp it down. And in all that process, you potentially can lose the shape. Why go through all that effort when there is a much simpler way to weld up a hexagon? Now, what's nice about this trick is that the only thing that is truly important that it gets accurate is the length. As long as the length is the same on all six pieces, you are going to have a nearly perfect hexagon every time. If this angle is a little too steep or not quite steep enough, this trick compensates for that. What's my hack? How do you make a nearly perfect hexagon every time? Tape. That's right, tape. I use masking tape in the shop all the time. I use it to make cut lines on a piece of metal that I'm working because you can feel the edge of the tape as the saw blade goes across it. I use it to hold things. Tape is a fantastic way to mark things and hold things in the shop. But not just masking tape. In this particular case, we also need electrician's tape. And you're about to see why. So the first step is we simply tape each joint together. Don't worry if they're not perfect. You just need them close. And you just need them roughly held in place. The tape's only sort of sticking because there's a little bit of oil from machining on these pieces, but still doesn't matter. We just need it sort of close. So we're gonna tape each joint, work our way around. All right, now here's where the magic happens. You take your electrician's tape and you put it all the way around the hexagon, or again, any gon that you choose to make your shape. But what's important is electrician's tape is stretchy. It has an elasticity to it. So we're going to take and put this right here, and we are going to start working our way around. First lap's the hardest because, again, like in this particular case, I have grease and oil on the part, so it's not sticking very well. But once you get a full revolution, you are tight. I am putting, as you can see, a lot of stretch on this tape, and I'm just pulling it around and getting it into position. Past the corner. Now, as you can see, by putting that equal pressure all the way around, this has trued up beautifully. Get this lined up. We'll take a measurement. We are right at, I'm gonna call that 9 13/16.
come exactly here, we do it again. And what do you know? 9 13/16. Now you can see right here, we have a slight gap and that's where the cut wasn't 100% accurate. But by doing this technique, it doesn't matter that that cut's not 100% accurate because it is held into a perfect hexagon. And so we can now fill in that gap with weld and our shape is going to be true. This stretchy compression, it gets us exactly where we need to be. Just to show you how well this tape works, you can now pick this up and it's holding together. All of the pressure is giving us a perfect connection. All of these joints are nice and tight on the inside there, and we are totally set up, ready to weld and have the perfect hexagon. Then once we do that, I have this sitting on a brake rotor because a brake rotor is fantastic for this type of job. It's a flat surface, it's metal, it's something you can clamp to. And then now that's what we do. It's held in place. We can clamp it down to the brake rotor so that it's flat in this plane. The tape is holding it in the octagon shape in that plane. And we can go around and tack weld. Once we have it totally tack welded and everything is exactly where we want it, we can remove the tape, we can remove it from the brake rotor, take the clamps off, and finish welding it. And you will have a nearly perfect hexagon every time.
If you like what you've seen, please click like. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.